Hello friends, I am Amarnath. Today I will discuss the topic of economic capital framework. So this is in news because recently Government of India has constituted a committee under the chairmanship of Bimal Jalan, the former governor of RBI, and six other members were also appointed to this committee to review the economic capital framework of RBI. So this committee was entrusted to bring out a suitable profit distribution policy taking into account all the likely situations that RBI would face. So this economic capital issue has become a bone of contention between the central bank as well as Union Government of India. This economic capital issue has become a bone of contention between the RBI and Ministry of Finance. So it is in this backdrop, so this issue is important for exam. Now, why RBI should transfer the capital to government? That is, we will discuss the reasons, the case in favor of transfer of capital from RBI to government. So here, excess capital of RBI can be used for recapitalization of public sector banks. That means the surplus capital, the surplus reserves of RBI can be used for recapitalizing the public sector banks which are facing the problem of crisis. So we have certain public sector banks which are facing the financial crunch. So this excess capital, the surplus capital can be used to recapitalize the banks. So it will help in liquidity management without having any impact on fiscal deficit. So this surplus transfer from RBI to government will have no impact on fiscal deficit. That is, it is the safest measure. It can be seen as a safe measure for liquidating the banks, for providing the capital support to banks. So as banks will have the adequate capital, now it can increase. This recapitalization of banks will help to increase capital flow into the markets. That is, it will help the availability of money in the market. So the increased capital flow in the markets will help in economic recovery of the banks, as well as it will decrease the dependency on the usage of government securities and foreign exchange reserves of government. So this is what the case in favor of transfer of surplus reserves from RBI to government. Now, if you take the other side of the coin, that is why RBI needs these resources. So why RBI should maintain this surplus resource? So it can help in market intervention operations. So whenever required, RBI can regulate the markets. It can intervene in the market operations. So it, as we know that RBI is the lender in the last resort. It is a banker to the government as well as a banker to the banks. So this RBI has every duty of acting as a lender of last resort. So this surplus fund, having of surplus funds with the RBI, will help RBI to lend at the last point. So, and de-risking the financial system. So ultimately, the monetary stability, the fiscal stability and inflation should be controlled. So RBI has the duty of maintaining monetary stability. It has the duty of controlling the inflation, right? And entirely, it has the duty of protecting the financial stability. So surplus funds with the RBI can help to discharge its duties. Right? So it is for this reason RBI want to maintain surplus funds. Right? So it will decrease dependency of RBI on government. So if surplus reserves are given to Government of India, then RBI will be left with meager amounts, with meager resource, where RBI cannot function well, where RBI cannot function in an independent way. It should depend upon government for all its lending operations. So for this reason, RBI want to maintain its own autonomy. So having of surplus funds will protect the autonomy of RBI and it will reduce the dependency of RBI on government, right? So here, by this, RBI can meet any financial risk without impacting the physical deficit. Without impacting fiscal deficit, right? So this is what the impact on, this is what the reasons which RBI gives. So we have both these arguments, where arguments in favor of transferring the surplus funds to government, at the same time why RBI should maintain these resources. So if you take the timeline even before this, so there are few points to note, right? So for the first time, it was in 2012-13 when Raghuram Ranjan was the governor of RBI, right? He constituted a technical committee under the chairmanship of Y.H. Malegaon to study how this RBI balance sheet should be presented. So a technical committee under the chairmanship of Malegaon was constituted by RBI with the task of recommending the way of presenting the balance sheet of RBI. So in 2013-14, to the same technical committee headed by Malegaon, right, this issue of capital, economic capital framework was referred, where Malegaon committee was required to review the level and adequacy of internal reserves of RBI and to come with a point on distribution of surplus reserves. That is, this Malegaon committee was required to make recommendations on surplus distribution policy of RBI. That means what should be the principles and methodology that should be used in transferring of surplus reserves from RBI to government. That means this issue, though it has figured in 2018-19 and 19-20, but it was long back, right? This issue was referred. So based on the recommendations of this Malegaon committee, right from 2013 itself, the RBI started transferring the surplus funds to Government of India. So in 2013-14, the RBI has transferred nearly 526 billion to the government, and it has transferred nearly 99.99% of its total surplus within 4 years. So right from 2013 till date, so as of now, so there is a transfer of funds from RBI to government. Now there is a contention going between the government and RBI, and the Bimal Janan committee has submitted its report, right? So this is the first part of the discussion. In the second part of the video, I will talk about the recommendations made by Bimal Jalan committee. So today in this video, I have given the background of the issue. So how it has come up. So today in this video, I have talked about the pros and cons of maintaining surplus reserves by RBI. In the next video, we will have a detailed discussion on the recommendations made by Bimal Jalan committee. So thank you. I hope you have understood the video. Thank you.